Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. As you will likely know, SpaceX made history on Wednesday or Thursday, depending on your time zone, by launching the first all-civilian mission to space with Inspiration 4. The booster which launched the mission, B-1062, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Step of an exciting and unexplored frontier. A few have come before and many are about to follow.
There was a cool shot posted on Twitter of Elon Musk with the Inspiration 4 crew before they left the hangar to get suited up for their trip to space. SpaceX posted a really cool video on Twitter with a view of the cupola, and what an incredible view it is. SpaceX also posted a tweet later saying the Inspiration 4 crew is healthy, happy and resting comfortably. Before the crew went to bed, they travelled 5.5 times around the Earth, completed their first round of scientific research and enjoyed a couple of meals. SpaceX then posted, after the crew wakes up today, they will conduct additional research and get their first look out of Dragon's cupola. There was a tweet posted on the Inspiration 4 Twitter account saying, true to their mission, the Inspiration 4 crew answered questions from St. Jude patients and future astronauts today from space. There was also another tweet from Inspiration 4 posted on Friday with some incredible shots of the crew in the capsule and looking out of the cupola. Apparently, Rook, Nova, Hanks and Leo spoke to Tom Cruise sharing their experience from space. At some point during their trip, the Inspiration 4 crew also gave an on-orbit update about how their trip was going and showed a few things as well. I also wanted to share this picture posted by the Inspiration 4 Twitter account. This is the menu of food in which the Inspiration 4 crew ate over the course of their mission. The caption of the tweet was a quote from one of the crew members of, "Can't believe we are eating cold pizza in space, it's extraordinary." There is a load of firsts that this mission has achieved, one of which is related to Psi and Proctor. This article says, while the mission itself is making history as the first all-civilian mission to launch to orbit, Proctor is accomplishing a major first herself as the first black female spacecraft pilot. There was another article about another first that was posted. It says, on Wednesday, Jared Isaacman made history on the Inspiration 4 as mission commander of the first all-civilian spaceflight. On Thursday, he made history again by placing the first sports bet made from space to Las Vegas. On Friday, Inspiration 4 posted a tweet about the splashdown. They said, our crew is returning to Earth tomorrow and will be the first Dragon crew to splash down in the Atlantic Ocean. Then, yesterday, the Inspiration 4 crew splashed down in the Atlantic Ocean to conclude their 3-day mission to space. I cannot wait to hear the stories and experience from the world's first all-civilian crew. Somebody posted a tweet saying that they would love to go to space one day before they die. Musk responded with, missions like Inspiration 4 help advance spaceflight to enable ultimately anyone to go to orbit and beyond. There was an interesting tweet posted by Eric Berger. It says, Benji Reed says, in the wake of Inspiration 4, the number of people approaching SpaceX about orbital flights is increasing significantly. I know they are already negotiating for missions 3 years from now. I'd expect demand greatly exceed supply. Musk was asked, when will Starlink come out of beta? He responded with, next month. Everyday astronaut asked Elon Musk, will Starlink be able to provide service for vehicles below and above them? It'd be great to have high-speed connection on orbit finally. Musk responded with, yeah, we'd use our Ka parabolics or laser links for Dragon, Starship or other spacecraft as soon as they got above cloud level. Gavin Cornwall posted a tweet related to SpaceX's recovery vessels. He said, SpaceX equipment is progressively being removed from support ship Go Quest as Bob and Doug replaces the role of the ship. Go Quest was one of the very first ships that SpaceX chartered way back in 2014 and a legend of 70 SpaceX missions. Emre Kelly posted a tweet about another launch which SpaceX has been given. He said, Turkey's Transport and Infrastructure Ministry has selected SpaceX and Falcon 9 for TurkSat 6A, the country's first domestically built comm satellite. completion in late 2022, followed by launch from KSC or CAPE in 2023. Taking a look at the Boca Chica action, here's a view of the launch site. Work is continuing on the orbital launch mount with B4 testing coming up soon. Also continuing on the chopstick catching arms for the tower. So too is the work on the suspected quick disconnect arm extension. Work has been continuing with the foundations for the wider high bay. Crews were seen working on the current high bay rooftop bar. There are some new structures being constructed. Michael Baylor posted a tweet in relation to an FAA document posted. It says the draft environmental assessment for Starship Super Heavy launches from Boca Chica concludes that the activities would not create significant noise impacts. There were some official renders also posted in the FAA document of the launch towers and how they will look with the catching arms. There was a new nose cone spotted being constructed in the tent. Some new Starship aero covers were delivered. Tank Watchers posted a tweet saying in the latest FAA stakeholder document dated September 2021, SpaceX revealed that Super Heavy is still expected to be equipped with up to 37 Raptor engines. This Raptor configuration was changed this year to a maximum of 32 Raptor engines according to Elon. Musk responded with 33. He then posted another tweet of, "With that, ship is basically begging for an extra 3 engines." Somebody posted a tweet saying Elon Musk shares SpaceX's Starship Raptor production plans to colonize Mars by 2050. Musk responded with, "This engine needs to be 10 times lower cost. Order of magnitude change is good reason for a new name. What really matters is not yet another advanced rocket engine, as there are many such devices, but there has never been a cheap less than $1,000 per ton force rocket engine. Not even close." A cryotank shell and new structure were rolled out to the launch site recently. Crews were seen working on the GSE-4 test tank. The ground support equipment tank GSE-8 is now fully stacked in the mid-bay. Starship 20 is sitting on suborbital pad B and the heat shield tiles look great. Taking a look at the upcoming Roden Beach closures on the Cameron County website, there's a date for tomorrow, Monday 20th, for possible testing. Then they also have further dates on Tuesday 21st, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, hopefully for a bunch of testing of possibly Booster 4 and Ship 20. Super Heavy Booster 5 stacking has been continuing in the high bay. The final piece of content to look at for this video, like usual, is the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. To finish up the video, I have to say thanks to Mary or Boca Chica Girl for being out filming the amazing content. Also, thanks to Nick Ansuini who has been out filming the amazing content as well. Plus, thanks to the NASA Space Flight team working behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.